Patrick, I sent you a photo of a thing to talk about. So I was thinking about this yesterday about memory and stuff, because I got a new cat. I got a little kitten, a little mush cat.
And what are you going to name it?
Mush cat.
Mush cat?
That's his name. Cat? Mush. All right. Mush the cat.
Isn't the cat redundant?
I have this mush.
Is the like the grieving period over for Joe, and now it's time to
move on? Well, it's an orange cat. He's an orange cat too. Oh. People are gonna think it's like I'm trying to replace Joe the cat. Joe the cat's like the third orange cat I own. I have a theory, and it's turned out to be true so far, like, with one glaring exception, and that is that orange male cats have the best personalities. The one exception being
Garfield?
No, fucking Seamus.
Heathcliff?
Your cat.
Seamus.
Seamus was Gus's cat, and he was a fucking nightmare.
He was not good.
He would do that deep bite. Like, he would bite and, like, draw blood.
I remember when I went to the, I got him from the shelter, the one that used to be down here on Town Lake. I went down to the shelter, and, you know, they have all the cats, like, in cat prison. They're all, like, behind cages. And I was walking through, and the reason Seamus stood out was he was reaching his right front paw out, like this. And I thought, oh, that's really kind of cute. He's like waving, trying to get attention. No, he was trying to scratch.
Yeah, I misinterpreted it.
I don't remember why, but eventually you decided that you no longer had room in your life for Seamus.
I had to move to a different place.
So I took Seamus over. And do you remember when we brought Seamus home and Sarah, first wife again, went up to it and stuck her face in front of Seamus and said, aren't you so cute? You're so cute. And she'd known the cat.
She knew
the cat
Seamus.
Had been a nightmare. Yeah. And you go, don't do that. And I go, don't do that. And she goes, it's okay. He's happy here. And right when she said that, he grabbed her right here and went, and she reached back, already in tears, blood everywhere. And that's what it was like until he moved on.
It was like a face hugger from Alien. Just.
She had scars.
It was bad.
I don't know if you remember this, but yep. He would sit at the top of the house on the roof where the roof crested, and he would sit there and he would just watch the neighborhood. And if he saw anything that he didn't like a dog that was 60 pounds bigger than him, he would run down the side of the house and take off after it.
He would chase cars. Remember that?
And one day he chased after something and he never came back.
Well, he would chase after raccoons all the time.
And I assume he's still on an adventure somewhere.
He's still running.
Yeah.
To this day.
He was the meanest, angriest animal.